One of the most common errors in prosthetic alignment results from insufficient consideration of the hip flexion contracture. This can cause hyperlordosis, back pain, and impairs prosthetic performance. The residual limb is unable to achieve full extension when there is a hip flexion contracture. Here we use the Thomas test to measure the angle at which compensatory movements become necessary to manage this limitation. First, determine the hip pivot point in the sagittal plane. Locate the top of the greater trochanter and mark it. Now locate the femur and mark it using adhesive tape. Have the user pull the sound knee towards the upper body and make sure the residual limb rests in a relaxed position. Slide one hand under the lumbar spine, move the residual limb with the other hand, while the user keeps the hip muscles relaxed. Push the residual limb into adduction and move it up and down, then lower the residual limb and hip extension until you feel the pressure on your hand reducing below the lumbar spine. This is the angle at which the compensation movement starts. Now measure the angle between the residual limb and the treatment table. Repeat this procedure a few times and use the average of the measurements to get the final result.